Welcome. Today we're doing the real secret behind detailed job costing. And you'll see our little character in the lower right hand corner who's looking very zen and happy with what he's doing. And hopefully that's going to tie in with our going with the flow concept that we're working with today. We're going to be focusing on the flexible item. This is one of the big secrets to job costing in QuickBooks, and there are a lot of different aspects to this. We've got a lot of material to cover, so I'm going to just move right along. First of all, we're going to cover what owners want from their job costing systems. That comes from my years of experience of working with people and finding out what it is they really want to know about their company's job costs. Some approaches that you don't want to use. Some of these we've learned through hard experience, and others we've seen other people try and not get the best results. But I think it's good to explain to you why those particular approaches aren't the most effective approaches to use. We're going to be looking at the inner nature of items. We're, again, that Zen theme today, trying to make things run smoothly and all of our systems working well together. Creating the items that will actually work for you and for your particular company. We're going to look at some item-based reports, maybe something a little different than what you've been used to looking at from prior sessions. And looking at the possibilities that we can, all the different kinds of things that we can do. And we'll wrap up with a little bit of relaxation. I don't have any Zen music going in the background, but we can all kind of put ourselves in that relaxation stage and see if we can save a little bit of time so we have just a little bit more relaxation and personal time in our lives. So we're going to use our PDF approach today. And some thoughts here on what owners usually want or need to see in order to control their job costs. But of course, you're going to want to check in and confirm with them and make sure that this is actually on target for your company. But this, I think, is going to be a good place for you to jump off and get started. So as far as actual costs go, usually they want to see some job stage cost roll-ups, and they want to be able to see big picture numbers for labor, their labor burden pool and allocations that are related to that. They want to see what they're spending on materials, on subcontractors. And of course, you kind of have to keep materials and subcontractors segregated there, and even from the term labor, because when we talk about labor, we're talking about internal employees. Even though you may be getting subcontractors to provide some of your labor, we need to keep those subcontractor costs segregated out for 1099s and all sorts of other job costs. Sometimes the owners also want to pick up heavy equipment cost assignments, customer allowances. That should actually have a little bullet in front of it, but it is the second thing there if they're tracking customer allowances, as well as detailed variances from purchase orders. And that can be handled at a very detailed level as well. Also, in many cases, they either want or they should be looking at time reports so that they can see actual time versus estimated time. And they need accurate results on a timely basis. When they look at time reports, they don't want to see that their labor costs are going sideways 2 or 3 weeks after the fact. So by using the items that we're going to be talking about today, you can actually get those types of reports. Additionally, they usually want to see some estimates and variances from estimates. And of course, everybody's looking at that gross profit by job number. And to kind of wrap things up on the expense side, staying on top of controlling costs with purchase orders and to be able to see open purchase orders by job to see what's out there and is outstanding. Okay, let's talk about a few things, what you don't want to do and why. So first of all, you don't want to use the chart of accounts for your job stages. Half a dozen reasons here. First of all, it creates a really long one-dimensional chart of accounts. It used to be that we couldn't do a lot of job costing in any way other than the chart of accounts. And so people tried to build these really elaborate chart of accounts that would help them do their job costing. We don't need to do that in QuickBooks. In QuickBooks, in our chart of accounts, we just kind of want to keep those big picture accounts, like I mentioned, labor, subcontractors, materials, other job costs. And of course, we can have more detail in our cost of goods sold area than that.